Hi friends, now we are doing numericals on flow through pipes. In the previous clip, I have given the theory and the formulas which are required to solve the problems on flow through pipes. Now we are going to solve a few problems. Now, November-December 2017 question paper. November-December 2017 question paper. 13B, problem number 13B, question number 13B, find the maximum power transmitted by a pipe. Find the maximum power transmitted by a pipe to a power station of 3 kilometers long. By a pipe to a power station of 3 kilometers long. The length of pipe is 3 kilometers. And 200 mm in diameter. Diameter is 200 millimeter. The pressure of water in the power station is 1500 kPa. This is the pressure. Take and F is equal to coefficient of friction is equal to 0.01. So this is the given data. With this data, we are asked to find what is the maximum power that can be transmitted. Now, first we'll convert this into meters, 3000 meters. This also into meters. This is 0.2 meters. This pressure must be converted into pressure head. So that is available head H is equal to available pressure divided by W. P by W gives me the head. So H is equal to 1500 divided by 9.81, because the liquid flowing here is water. For water, the specific weight is 9.81. You should remember that. So 1500 divided by 9.81 will be 152.9 meters of water. This is the available head. Now, we know the condition for maximum power transmission. The condition is HF, that is head loss due to friction, must be 1/3 of the available head, that is 152.9 divided by 3. That works out to divided by 3 works out to 50.97 meters. So I got HF. Now I have L and D. I have to find out the maximum power. You know, maximum power is equal to WQ into H minus HF. So many kilowatts. Now I have W. I know W. I know now H. I know HF. H is 152.9 meter. We have got it. HF we have got as 50.97 meters. Now we have got these values, but I don't have Q. Now without Q, I cannot get power. So first I have to find power. Q. I have to find the discharge. How to find the discharge? I know HF is equal to, I have the formula, FLQ square divided by 3D to the power of 5. See here, HF I know, I have got HF here, F is given, L is given, D is given. So the only unknown in this equation, in this relationship, is Q, and because it is the only unknown unknown value there, I can get the value of Q from this equation. Now if you cross multiply, F L Q square is equal to HF into 3 d to the power of 5. HF into d to the 3 d to the power of 5 is equal to FL Q square. So Q square will be equal to HF into 3 d to the power of 5 divided by F into L. So Q will be square root of this, square root of HF into 3 d to the power of 5 divided by F into L. Now square root of, make the substitution, HF we have got 50.97 into 3 into d to the power of 5, d is 0.2 to the power of 5 divided by F, F is 0.01 multiplied by L, L is 3000 meters. So we have everything there. So we'll get it. Now 50.97 into 3 into 0.2 to the power of 5 to the power of 5 divided by 0.01 divided by 3000 gives me, 1 minute, 50.97 into 3 into 0.2 to the power of 5 divided by 0.01 divided by 3000 is equal to 1.63 something into 10 to the power of minus 3, square root of the answer, square root of answer equals 0.04 cubic meters per second. This is the discharge. This is the discharge. Now the power, that is the maximum power, because we have used the condition for maximum power here, so we are going to get the maximum power. Power, the formula is P is equal to W Q into H minus HF. This is 9.81 into 0.04 into H is 152.9 minus 50.97. Now this will give us, first subtract that, 152.9 minus 50.97 equals, that is, 1 minute, 152 point, this gives me 39.99, say 40 kilowatts. This is the power that can, maximum power that can be transmitted by using that pipeline. So this is one problem carrying 6 marks from your old question paper of November, December 2017. Next, now April, we'll take one more problem from the paper, April May 2017 examination. problem number 14b. 14b. Yeah, and again for 6 marks. A pipe of 300 meter length. Length of the pipe is 300 meter. With diameter 0.3 meter. D is 0.3 meter. Is supplying water. Calculate the discharge of water. Calculate the discharge of water through the pipe. If the loss of head due to friction, HF, is 1.5 meter, take Darcy's coefficient, that is F, as 0.01. So we are asked to find the discharge. Now the formula to be used is, it's a very simple problem. HF is equal to FLQ square divided by 3D to the power of 5. Here I know HF. HF is given, F is given, L is given, D is given, and I am asked to find Q. That is the only unknown quantity in that formula. So that can be found out. Now Q is equal to root of HF, square root of HF into 3D to the power of 5, divided by F into L. So square root of HF, HF is 1.5 meters into 3 into D to the power of 5, 0.3 to the power of 5, divided by F is 0.01 into L is 300 meters. This is the given data, and we will calculate this and see what is the 645 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Root answer, square root answer is equal to 0.06 cubic meters per second. That's all. You have to find out only discharge. We have found out discharge through the pipe. This is the problem. Next problem I take from the question bank, your question bank. Question number 14 in question bank. Find the head loss due to friction in a pipe of diameter. So HF is to be found out. What is to be found out is head loss due to friction in a pipe of diameter 300 mm. Diameter is 300 mm. That is 0.3 meter. Through which water is flowing at a velocity of 3 meters per second. V is 3 meters per second. Using Darcy's formula, number 1, Darcy's formula. Use Darcy's formula. Taking F as 0.0026. And by using Chazzi's formula, taking C as 60. So here we have to find HF two times, once by using Darcy's formula and the other time using Chazzi's formula. Both the formula we have to use. Now here first, if you use Darcy's formula, using Darcy's formula, HF is equal to 4FLV square by 2GD. So HF is what is to be found out. We know all other things. Here I have missed out length. Length of pipe is given as 50 meter. Length of pipe is 50 meter. So all other things are known. 4, F is 0.0026, L is 50 meters, V is 3, so 3 square, divided by 2 into 9.81 into D is 0.3 meters. So I get this direct substitution, 4 into 0.0026 into 50 into 3 square divided by 2 divided by 9.81 divided by 0.3 equals. I am getting 0.795 meters of water, meters of liquid you can write. This is the head loss due to friction if you use Darcy's formula. If you use Chazzi's formula, if you use Chazzi's formula, what do we get? Now Chazzi's formula is, Chazzi's formula, V is equal to C root MI. Now V is 3, C is 60, M is D by 4. For circular pipe, M is D by 4, so D is 0.3 divided by 4, 0.075 meter. Hydraulic mean depth. So I know V, I know C, I know M, I can get I from here. I can be calculated. How? We do one thing. So square both the sides. So V square will be equal to C square into MI. So I will be equal to V square divided by C square into M. I will be equal to C, V square divided by C square into M. So V is 3 meters per second. So 3 square divided by 60 square into M is 0.075. So we will see what we get. What do we get? 9 divided by 60 square divided by 0.075. I get I is equal to 0.33333 I get. So now HF is equal to head loss due to friction is equal to I into L, that is 0.0333 into L. L is 50, so that will be into 50. It will give me 1.66 meters of liquid. This is HF by this formula, that is HF from that formula for the given values. So that completes the problem. We'll take up one more problem. We'll do one more problem on flow through pipes. Problem number 8, again from the question bank. I have selected problem number 8. A reservoir has been built 4 kilometers away from a college campus having 5,000 inhabitants. Means, length of the pipe to be laid is 4 kilometers. The reservoir is supply, reservoir is 4 kilometers away. So, a length of pipe to be laid is this thing. The number of people, inhabitants, number of people living in the hostel is 5,000. In the campus is 5,000. Water is to be supplied from the reservoir to the campus. It is estimated that each inhabitant will consumption per head per day is 200 liters, and that half of the daily supply is to be pumped in within 10 hours. Half of daily supply to be pumped in 10 hours. Calculate the size of the supply main, that is, size means we have to find out the dia of the pipe. If the loss of head due to friction is 20 meters, that is HF is equal to 20 meters, take F is equal to 0.008, Darcy's coefficient is 0.008. If F is given, it means that we have to use Darcy's formula. If C is given, we have to use Chazy's formula, like that. Now, we have to find out the dia of the pipe for this requirement. Now, from this data, first I have to find out what is the discharge. Now, discharge Q, discharge through the pipe, will be equal to population, that is number of people, into daily consumption per head. Into half of this will give me the one days, this thing, divided by, this is to be half a days, this thing, this is to be supplied in 10 hours, 10 into 60 into 60 seconds. 1 hour has 60 minutes, 1 minute, each minute has 60 seconds. So this is the time in which it is to be pumped in number of seconds. So this is 5000, this will be 0.2 cubic meters to 200 divided by 1000 into half or 0.5. So Q will be equal to 5000, number of people, daily consumption per head, that is 0.2 cubic meters, into half, that is half of this supply is to be completed in 10 hours. This will give me Q in cubic meters per second, because this I have put in cubic meter and I have converted time into seconds. Now, 5000 into 0.2 into 0.5 divided by 10 divided by 60 divided by 60. I will get this as 0.014, almost 138. You can take it as 0.14 cubic meters per second. This is the peak supply. Peak supply is 0.014 cubic meters per second. For this supply, what should be the diameter of the pipe? Now, next we have to use the formula HF is equal to FLQ square divided by 3D to the power of 5. Here, we know HF, we know F, we know L, we have got Q, we have to find out D. D is the only unknown quantity there, so that can be found out. Right? We can find out that. So, I'll rub out this. Now, cross multiplying, I get HF into 3D to the power of 5 is equal to FLQ square. Cross multiplying this, I get like this. So, D to the power of 5 is equal to FLQ square divided by HF into 3. These two will be sent this side. Next, D is equal to D is equal to FLQ square divided by HF into 3 whole to the power of 1 by 5. It can be written like this, or it can be written as 5th root of FLQ square by HF into 3. Next, substitute these values. F is given as 0.008. L is given as 4 kilometers. Convert it into meters, 4000 meters. So that is 4000. Q is 0.014 square divided by HF is 20 into 3 whole to the power of 1 by 5. First, simplify this. 0.008 multiplied by 4000. 4000 multiplied by 0.014 square. Now I got this as 1.0453 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Whatever is the answer, keep it like that. Now I want the fifth root of this. This can be done in two ways. 1 by 5 is 0.2. So I can press 0.2 to the power button and 0.2 if I put, I'll get the answer. Or I can get the fifth root also. See here, press 5, shift, power, answer equals. I am getting this as 0.1599 meters, or you can take it as 0.16 meter. This should be the dia of the pipe. The size of the pipe is 0.16 meters. That should be the dia of the pipe to give the required discharge in the required time. Thank you, friends. Please share and subscribe my channel.